Hi, I'm Don Norman. I've just come back to the University of California at San Diego to start the design lab. Over the years, I've done a large number of things. I've taught, I was a vice president at Apple, startup companies. What we spend a lot of time on in design is trying to understand the real needs of people. And for this, we don't ask, we watch, because what people think they need is often not really right. So we try to watch and understand what people do, how they use the products or services we're talking about. And then there are many factors that go into why you like something. You know, in the last century or so, science has placed huge emphasis upon logic and rational thinking, and that's misplaced. We're not logical, we're emotional. There are two kinds of things going on in the brain. One we call cognitive, which is trying to understand the world, but the other is emotional, which in many ways is more important, because what emotions are about assigning value. And value is what's of critical importance to us as human beings. So as a simplification, we said there are just three levels of emotion. One we call visceral, which is automatic. We're born with it. So we like sweet tastes and we don't like bitter tastes. The second is behavioral, and that's, well, how we use something, how we learn to understand it. Can we predict what's going to happen? Do we understand? Does it feel good? The third level is reflective. It's the most conscious. The other two are subconscious. But the conscious level is where we think back about what we did, whether we liked it or didn't like it, or evaluate it. Look, emotion is a very powerful system in the body. And it's to say that we've reacted emotionally instead of intelligently, that's wrong. No, there's an emotional intelligence. The most favorite objects that we have are ones that have a story, that have an emotional attachment. So people might love, what's their favorite teacup? It's this old teacup that's even cracked. But especially if it was handed down from your grandmother to your mother to you, yeah, it tells a story. And it's wonderful when it captures the mind and the heart and the body. And that's what people cherish most. You know, design is all about fitting people's needs. And our needs vary. Sometimes we need something that really works well, and I don't care what it looks like. And sometimes we want something that just makes us feel good. You know, we might buy a pair of shoes that are really uncomfortable, but we just love the way they look, and so we don't care. We'll suffer the discomfort because it makes us feel good. Some things maybe should be more functional and efficient, and some things more warm and loving and emotional. We need this balance between the two. You know, I've written many, many books, but I wrote one entire book on emotional design. But I also write books on how to make things that people can understand and actually use. And we have to do both.